top of the toast. raise your glass to a beautiful ceremony, to a very good-looking bridal party, looking like the cast of America's Next Top Model got lost in the GQ magazine. And to Tammy, for absolutely stopping the show when she walked down the aisle, and for sharing her birthday with us today. Yay! Cheers! And that just shows you what kind of a girl Tammy is. She was gracious enough to only give Will one day to remember each year. So Will asked me to be the best man, and I responded by saying, of course, I've always been the best man. What I found out is this meant that I had to give a speech. Now, as many of you I'm sure are aware, public speaking is the number one fear in America. The number two is being burned alive. So thank you, Will. I really appreciate it. For those that don't know me, I am the brother of the groom. So you're probably thinking at this point, the speech kind of writes itself, right? All I have to say is I don't feel like I'm losing a brother. I feel like I'm getting a sister. But I didn't want to say that. So I turned to YouTube and I found some good stuff there. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, in the So, Will and I grew up together, right? We have this thing that Tammy lovingly refers to as a bromance. Remember when we were 12 years old, running around the living room in our diapers, sharing playful secrets, and throwing sticks in front of rollerbladers in the park? And then Will went off to Buffalo and came back with a third wheel. I didn't like this at first, but Tammy soon found her way into my heart, as she has with all of yours, I'm sure. And I didn't want to say I don't feel like I'm losing a brother, I feel like I'm getting a sister, because I've been calling Tammy my sister for about 4 years now. That's how close we've been. So the only difference now is it's Facebook official. When I was getting ready to write this, I asked them for three characteristics that describe the other person. I immediately get a text back from Will that says, wow, she's beautiful, she's down to earth, and she's charismatic. And then I get a text back from Tammy that says, let me get back to you.
She was at work.
She did get back to me, and she said these three things. He's imaginative, he's diligent, and he's chivalrous. And I'm sharing this for two reasons. I want you guys to know, and I want everyone to know, the very deep respect and admiration that these two people share. And it never hurts to have brownie points for that one time that you do forget August 23rd. I also asked them what they want their relationship to be known for, and they said these three things. They want to be known for being best friends, they want to be known for being passionate about each other, and for having a love that can get them through anything. I don't think there's anything better that I can wish for you two. Will, you're my brother, you're my best friend. I've always looked up to you. I love you. You're going to be a great husband and father. And I can't wait to share in your life with your new bride. So please, raise your glass with me. May you always have companionship, passion, and a love that goes stronger and deeper each and every day. To Will and Tammy.
Everybody, and start by saying how absolutely beautiful Tammy. Hey Will, you look pretty good too. Tammy and I met 7 years ago. We were forced into hanging out when Will and my fiance Dan would have their little mandates of video gaming and spooning. Tammy and I ended up getting really, really close. Through that, because we'd be left alone in the other room together, so we didn't really have a choice. But there were many, many conversations of when Will and Tammy would get married and when Dan and I would get married, and these were always conversations about when. They were never conversations of if. There are also many conversations of when we have families together, and our children playing together, but I'll save those for their many, many, many baby showers in the future. I would like to share a few words of advice for Will. First is a quote by Lyndon B. Johnson. I have learned that only two things are necessary to keep one's wife happy. First, let her think she's having her own way. And second, let her have it. Tammy, can you put your hand on the table? Will, can you put your hand on top of Tammy's? Now take a good look, because that's probably the last time you'll ever have the upper hand over Tammy. Success in marriage is more than finding the right person. It's being the right person. And I'm proud to be here celebrating the marriage of these two special people, who are not only amazing in their own right, but are also the right people for each other. So, please raise your glasses. To love, to laughter, and happily ever after. To Tammy and Will.
Thanks, Jenny. At this time, it is my pleasure to turn the floor over to Grandma Lynn, who is going to say her blessing before our viewers.
Yeah, I'm kind of indirectly responsible for this little life. Anyway, let's put ourselves before the Lord. Oh, good God, thank you for the gift of Tammy and the gift of Will. And the gift of their love for each other. Thank you for bringing all these precious people together to celebrate this awesome event. And Lord, bless our food and bless our fellowship. May we celebrate in a way that brings not only us pleasure, but you pleasure too. Amen.
Amen.
It is now my pleasure to announce that dinner is ready to be served. If you could just please remain at your table, you will be released by me or my partner. Thank you.